Welcome everybody. We are GSI, basically GigaSoft India, and now I am going to start with a demonstration on our tools OptiSystem and OptiSpice. So first of all, I shall be concluding with a general overview of what we are. So we are incorporated in 2010, and we supply the tools to different neighboring countries, SAR countries you can say. So we are responsible for whole sales as well as technical part, and being Dellsoft is our business partner, so they are authorized to promote our products in India, and they very well have organized this session. So I think a general overview is sufficient. Like, we have some customer base, and the main thing is OptiWave products. So this is what I'm gonna focus on: OptiSystem and OptiSpice. So I will just give you a little overview on OptiWave products, what OptiWave deals in. Okay, OptiWave is a company located at Ottawa in Canada, and they deal in photonic design and simulation tools, and these are the tools available in OptiWave. OptiSystem is the hotcake selling product. It is basically used for optical communication network simulation designs. You can design a link in a physical layer, and you can simulate for different analysis and results. OptiSpice is a first optoelectronic circuit design software. It's basically a combination of different electronic as well as optoelectronic components. You very well connect the same and have a circuit, simulate it, and the simulation is also available in different patterns. So I will let you know in our further demonstration. OptiAbility is basically used to design different passive component, like you have fog, you have switches, or you want to design a ring resonator. So these are some basic applications of OptiAbility. So you can design a component with its particular, you can say, waveforms, and it's being used for different analysis. Like in OptiSystem, we have different multiplexers, we have photonic crystal fibers. So you can use to design this fibers or crystals, photonic crystals in OptiAbility. OptiBPM. OptiBPM is a beam propagation method based software, so you can design your own circulators, your own boards. So it is very much similar to Ability, but apart from crystal simulation, we can use BPM for its propagation method designing. Optic gratings used for fiber grating design. You can get ready with your own sensors like FPG sensors. Fine. So you there is an option in OptiSystem that you can make your own component in optic grating, say a sensor or a grating, and you can use the same as a component in OptiSystem. So this is one of the you can say a good GUI feature. Fiber, on other hand, is used to design different fibers, and we can do a different model analysis. Like we have a lot of parameters in regard of fiber, like dispersions, attenuations, and we have different type of losses, and each fiber is comprises of a respective material. So different materials are being used to design the fiber. Fine. So let me start with our first Opti system. So this is how our software window looks like. This is basically a window in which you can design your layout. We have a free space here. You can drag and drop the components, interconnect with each other, simulate it, and have results. Next is, these are just the visualizers, like what you can analyze. We have a component library here where we can have a different form of visualizers. Optical spectrum is one of them, WDM analyzer. This is just to analyze what is happening over a circuit. Fine. Now next slide is of Q factor. Q factor analysis is very much important when we you can say simulate a network in a physical link. Like we have a transmitter, we have a channel, and we have a receiver. So this process should have a quality, like what we process, what we transfer from our transistor part. So we can basically receive the same with some quality factor. So the quality factor should be high in order to achieve a good result. Now these are some you can say technical portion, like what we basically have in this Opti system tool. So we have different type of analysis of DPSK signals. Next is optical amplifier design. I'm not stressing on this technical portion. I will just give you an overview that what we have and what we can do. And when I will shift on the software part, I will let you know that what sort of things you can do and what type of work till now has been done on this software. Now, optical amplifier design. Optical amplifier designs, you can say we have a different amplifiers in our component library. So EDFA, YDFA, EYDFA, erbium doped, ytterbium doped, we have a different combination sets of amplifiers also. So we can use it. These are, you can say, new strategic components available in the market. The main feature is we can interface this library with our MATLAB. Like you can design your own system, or you can design a simple function. And if you want to use the functions designed in your MATLAB as a component in Opti system, you have a platform here to interface MATLAB with Opti system. I will let you know how we can do the same. Just go with the flow now. So like this is a code of a MATLAB file. I don't know which code it is, but it's some function. Fine. So we can simulate the same with the Simulink and interface the same .m file. We have designs of CATV systems. We can design a CATV community antenna televisions. So we can design the same. We have different links. The most important feature is now free space optics. These are some categorized fields in optics. So a lot of people are working on FSO. So in regard of this, OptiWave have designed two components for FSO. One is this FSO itself, FSO channel, and another is wireless communication channel. So I will show some examples of it during my technical presentation. We can use like OWC channel. This is what I'm talking about, optical wireless channel. So this channel is basically used for inter-satellite communication. It means you can do a far distance communication. Fine. we have some optimizations and why we use Opti system. I will go with this slide. I will be just shifting over to my software. So here we go. So now I think it is visual and it's audible to you. So this is how our this window of Opti system looks like. For that, we just have to click on a new layout, or you can go with the file and all. This is a basic software usability concepts. So I think everybody is used to operate software, a simple software, any software you can operate. So this is just a better GUI provided by OptiView. So now coming on to the components, here we have a component library. So we have a layout here. We have these components available in our library. First of all, I will start with some of the components so that you can easily review that what sort of components we have. Optical spectrum analyzer, time domain, power meter. In electrical also we have oscilloscopes, different RF spectrum analyzers. We have transmitters, like different sources. We have CW laser, laser wizard, LED, pump laser. So the sources we have. Next we have bit sequence generators, pulse generators, modulators. We have optical transmitters. So we have a variety of libraries here. So let me start with a simple example. In today's demo also I have used a simple layout. So let me start with something. Let me take a source. then I put using a pulse generator. Let it be triangle. No. Which one? Okay, simple sine is sufficient. I think. Sine. And now I will require a modulator now. Max Zander modulator. So you can see a good feature of this software. When I have dropped this component, just look at the connection. I'm deleting it. I'm again dropping it here. It has a feature that while drag and drop the components get connected to each other. Fine. So this is a good feature. Now you can see here that this is my transmission part. I am generating a signal. We have a source. I am modulating the same and we are ready to go. Now if I use a simple fiber, you must be looking after the component parameters. So if I double click on any one of the component, we can have the parameters of the same, like we have frequency, power, line width, initial phase. You can change it from here. Just click it on OK and your component is ready. Same as it is of sine generator. You can change the frequency according to requirement. Now we have a fiber here. Transmission portion is over. We have a fiber. Double click on the fiber. The length is 50 kilometer. It's by default. You can change the length. Apart from that, we have other parameters of this optical fiber, the group velocity, third order dispersion, and like you can say the add-on dispersion which we can add in the fiber. These are by default and we can change. Now this is transmission, this is a channel. Now I would like to receive it. So to receive, I will go inside a receivers library. Okay, I'm getting it in a receiver pin diode, pin follow diode. And now I will see what is happening over here, what I am doing basically. We have an analyzer here, oscilloscope analyzer. I have connected at the receiver end. Now if I simulate it, what I shall be getting here is this. This is not clear because the frequency is very high. I think I can use it here also, so I can get to know that what I am transmitting and what I am receiving. Oh, this is also high. So I can do is just change the frequency. Let it be 5. Okay, simulate it again. Finished. Okay, now I have, this is again, I'm getting it, but again it is high. If I give here 500 megahertz, great. I am sending this signal basically, and I am receiving this. This is signal, this is noise, this is the combination of all. Now I think I must use a filter here. So I can use the filter. We have a filter. Low-pass special filter. Now if I simulate it, okay, I'm getting this. So this is my signal. It has some errors, but after all I'm getting my signal near to that. This is basically an R&D, so if I want to amplify the data after when it is processed through a fiber, so I can also use an amplifier level. Can use EDFA. Sorry, I have connected wrongly. So here I can connect it. Okay. So let us see if we get something. Not much. That is 80 and here we have a single amplitude. So it is amplified. Now this is a simple way to tell you that what we cover here is transmission, a channel, and a reception. So I will be telling you some more features of software. Let me go with example. So we have a number of samples. So if you can see the fields in which we can use this software, like in advanced modulation systems, we can design our PSK systems, PAN, OFDM systems. We have different formats for the simulations. These examples are basically published in different journals, like some in IEEE and some are in other international journals. So these are being published using OPTI system. So let me take an example of a published paper, dispersion compensation pre, post and symmetrical. This is a simple analysis of how dispersion is compensated when a single mode fiber, or you can say dispersion compensation fiber. The dispersion compensation fiber is being used here. The main work is of dispersion compensation fiber only. So we have three layouts within a one. So first of all, pre means dispersion compensation fiber is attached before single mode fiber in a whole process. We will check it out that how we have compensated the dispersion and what quality factor we would be getting. So basically the aim is to get a good quality factor here. So we have different formats of this project. So let me simulate it and we'll tell you the process now. This is our transmission part. We have here is a CW laser as a source, a different random bits, the pseudo random bits by default. We have a user defined bit sequence generator also. You can write the order here according to your requirement. So we have a random bit generator, then NRZ pulse generator. It generates NRZ pulses. And we are modulating this hole. After modulating it through a Maxander modulator, here it will be passed through a loop control. So loop control is a component which is being used to repeat a process which is being taken care by a channel. So every process taken place is in channel only, and it's a sort of bypassing agent. So you can see here, so this is our transmission part is over. Now when we are transmitting it through a loop control, the process goes like this. It goes in DCF, dispersion compensation fiber, whose length has been written as a 24 kilometer. You can change the length. EDFA is our generalized default component, but here you can see that the gain has been changed here. This is 12.8 dB. So this is all a sort of a research work. Then single mode fiber with 120 kilometer. Again we are using EDFA, but now with 20 dB gain. So we are passing it. Again it will come back to loop control. Then again it will start the process, because here we have number of loops are 2. Some doctorate has designed this layout for research purpose, and this number 2 loops are maybe favorable for his project, so he has taken 2. So after all the process through this, when we are checking out that dispersion compensation fiber is pre-situated in the process. So now we detect it on a photodetector pin, then we filter it and we'll see the results. Now here if you can able to see, we have a BER analyzer here. So BER analyzer is basically used to check the quality factor as well as bit error rate in the whole process. Process of what? That what we have transmitted and what we are receiving it at the receiver. So it will compare, it is comparing the generated pulse with pseudo random bits as well as what is being received. So it is a comparison of this transmission and reception. So now we can easily analyze what is Q factor. I will simulate the layout now. So it is simulated. I think the connection has been lost. Okay, I will be again simulating. So I will simulate this. So it's simulated. It takes only seconds to calculate. Like you can see here, it has taken only 9 seconds to simulate. But I think over internet, you can see it takes a lot of time for you to analyze that, how much time it takes for simulation. So our layout has been simulated. Now let me check that what quality I'm getting here is. Okay, this is the quality. So I'm getting a peak over here. You can zoom out. I'm getting a peak and my maximum Q factor is 58.703. So this is my quality factor with respect to time period. So I'm getting a peak with the maximum Q factor of 58.07. So this is a good because we are getting a peak. We can see other results also, like minimum bit error rate is this. So at a point it goes constant, fine. Threshold, height, and the BER is not available, we haven't got. This is the eye diagram basically. So it's a smooth opening and we have a very less interference here. My eye opening is smooth. So it's a good factor that we are achieving something at reception. So the quality may be a good one. So this is how we have analyzed that what quality we are getting when we attach a DCF component or when we use dispersion compensation fiber before a single mode fiber in a process. And when I talk about post analysis, like when we use a dispersion compensation fiber after single mode fiber, the layout is same, the transmission, then we have only interchanged here is the fiber, single mode fiber comes before dispersion compensation fiber. We have amplifiers, again we are adapting, and then we simulate it. It's simulating and we shall be getting the results. So I think it's simulated. Evaluation has been finished. I'm closing the window. Now I shall be showing you the analysis. So I will be checking it out. Okay, great. I'm getting a peak over here. Again, if it's a slow process, I will let you know. So this is the quality factor we are getting here. The quality as compared to a pre layout which we have designed is very much good than this. This is a post analysis and we are getting 66 a Q factor. Same as minimum bit error rate, threshold, height and eye diagram. So this is the eye height, and in case here you get to know that what we have analyzed, like post layout is better than pre, means when we use a single this dispersion composition fiber after single mode, then we can get a better quality factor. And in case if we combine the both layouts, like in symmetrical process, here I have a combination of both. It's all under channel. This is our channel, so I'm just playing with the components here. A combination of pre, then a combination of post, dispersion compensation, EDFA, SMF, then post components, SMF, EDFA, DCF. So symmetrical way, if we simulate it, I have already simulated, let's simulate it again. This symmetrical layout is being submitted, and now if I check the quality factor, we have a quality factor of 62, means okay, it is something good but not better than the post analysis. So what we have concluded in this project is post layout is the best among these three analyses. So this is how this has been written or published. Apart from this, I will tell you that this is just a layout. We have done the simulations. Now the main matter here is how we can collect the data. So every researcher or every student, you can say, who is using this software must know how to calculate the results. I have simulated it, and if I want to collect the data, I can simply go to a project browser. So under view, you can just click on this project browser, and we have a window here. So I think it is now clear to you. Now what we can do here is we have used a BER analyzer. So under BER analyzer, we have graphs. So coming under graphs, we have these graphs available with us. Means it's an extract of a full layout, but what you have cooked till now. This is the main thing. So if I double click on it, I'm getting an amplitude histogram. Same amplitude probability, eye amplitude, that is more important. How the amplitude of an eye, means eye opening, you can say maximum the opening of an eye, it is, you can say, proportional to a good network, a good signal, a good reception part. Eye height, a Q factor, how a Q factor behaves. Time histogram, means we have a lot of options available here with us. We can collect these data and very well can use it when we will publish our results. And if you want to see the graphs and under dispersion compensation fiber, so we are getting a value of 10. This is the attenuation. Every component has its own features, and the main function of this project browser is to give you the results in the form of graphs, and we can have the graphs of only those components whose analysis is available, like what that DCF compensation fiber has analyzed when the data has been passed. This is what we have. And in the same way, if I want to see what has been passed through SMF, or I can see the attenuation. So this is all the graphs we can have here. Next is how to use and how to save. For example, if I use this again, and now I want to save this eye diagram. Let's say in my project, I want to show it. So just click on this tab, copy image to clipboard. And we can save it. So this is how I have saved in Microsoft Word, just copy and paste, nothing else. And if apart from this graphical features, if I want to save the coordinates, like this is a graph and it must have coordinates, so to save that, these are the x and y values. So I can export it, say a data, anything I can save with the name. Let it be a result. I have saved them. So here is the file I have. I have this text file with me with the results x and y coordinates. Closing it. So this is the way how I can save my results, save my analysis. Like we have analyzed spectrum of this location, that after a channel what we are getting at the output of loop control, this is a spectrum we are getting. So as much as results you can collect it, like power, they have used a power meter. These are the results. Okay, one thing more I will show you, that if you want to combine the graphs, like you want to see the Q factor with Y opening factor, just view it. So I think you can view it now. Here we have a combination of eye opening factor with the Q factor. Here you can change the properties, like properties of the graph, what type of graph you need. Some of the good features. The connection has been restored now. So what I was telling to the people is the collection of data. So in case, at last I will tell you the most important feature of this. If we want to collect the data of whole layout, so in that case you can export the layout to Excel. So I can save my results here. So you can analyze from here. We have the parameters of CWSR. Pseudo random bit sequence generator. So we have different parameters of each component. So whatever we have used in this layout, we have collected all the data in a single Excel file. So it's a good practice to collect all the data. So it will be easy for researchers to keep it safe, and they can very well use it during the presentation or when they publish the papers. And some little things about the software. We have different features of software, like I have already told you, auto connect on drop feature. When we drag and drop a component, it automatically connects with another component. But in case your connection is lost, for example, this is being disconnected, like I'm disconnecting the connections. For example, this is this is unconnected layout now. So I will just click on this auto connect on move, and I will just move a component and it will get connected to the other one. Or you can simply connect it yourself. So this is one of the features, and one main thing now I will tell you that how efficiently we can use this in case our the layout is very complex, like if you can say this is a complex layout. This is not a complex, but let's say this is a complex layout consisting of number of components, and we just want to settle the things. So what I can do is, starting from here, I can select these components, just right click on it, create a subsystem. Now I am left with only this portion what I have not selected, means that I can reduce the complexity. This is inside of a subsystem. So again, I have undo the process. So this is how it is beneficial to you. So just giving you a quick overview of OptiSpice now. I think in OptiSystem it is enough for you people to understand that how it actually works and what are the features of the software. Rest, if you people want to evaluate the software of the system, you can contact your this dealer Dellsoft. Fine. Further to that, we have a large number of library here. You can go through that if in case you want to evaluate. Next is, I will be starting with some overview of OptiSpice, a quick overview. I know we are running time, but I will just give you an overview of what is OptiSpice that has been launched in 2010, and of course with the partnership of Carleton University. This is basically a platform, a simulation platform, where you can group the analog and digital components. You can design in a circuit and simulate it. Like, I think in ORCID PSPICE, everybody has gone through ORCID PSPICE or any other SPICE software, whether it is multi-sim or other. So it is very much resembling to that, but here we have optoelectronic components also. And this is one of the greatness of the software, that no other software includes the optoelectronic components, like laser drives we have, electronic equalizers, optical libraries, CW sources, modulators, and even you can design your own JFETs, MOSFETs. Now this is the main slide from where you can just analyze that how it works. This is the main architecture. So this is a scheme editor. First, we have a schematic editor. We can draw our circuit and we can simulate it with different simulation formats, and after simulation we will have a waveform. We will do the analysis of waveform, what we are getting, and then the last stage is parameter extraction of, you can say, lasers, filters, whatever devices you are using. So it is having an ability to import with the HSPICE. HSPICE is a common tool, so everybody is using for analog and digital simulation. SPICE is a language, so this is the slide. You can identify that, you can program it if you know a SPICE language. A lot of people, a lot of lecturers, professors are working on SPICE models or SPICE programming, so they can very well understand that this is a SPICE language, and you can write your own SPICE program here and you can run it. So this is example, like what we are working on now. We are working on the upgrades actually, which will be releasing on July. So this is a semiconductor optical amplifier. So we are going to develop a semiconductor optical amplifier through this OptiSPICE, as well as waveguides and micro rings. So a component using this OptiSPICE can be made for the performance analysis. So this is a short overview. I will just go through a SPICE example, not taking your much time, so that we can have at least 5 minutes for your queries. So this is OptiSPICE schematic software. I will be just going through a demo. Okay. So this is a simple circuit, a simple RLC, you can say. Here we have used probes. This is a voltage probe. This is a control. And rest, you know, resistors, capacitors. So here we have a component library. This is a component library. For example, if you want to have a resistor, you can just type resistor, and whatever related to resistor will come here. Just double click on it and paste it here. So I will do analysis now, just running this. So after simulation, this is basically a transient simulation. So after the simulation, here we have two options. Like, if we want to use the result of this circuit as a component in an optic system, we have an option here. I just have to click it to launch it. Okay, this is what I got. This is the simulated result, whatever has been simulated there. I have just launched that in Optis system, and we get here it as a component. Further, if we go inside, we have a option here to introduce whether it as a delay, number of iterations we want. That's all we have. We can use this component in our any layout, wherever you want, according to the requirement. And in case I want to use the another option, that is launch a waveform viewer, here we have a waveform viewer window. Transient graphs. Double click on it. Current and voltage. Okay, so here I am getting this. I can do one thing also. I have interfaced this in with Office. If I want to check it that how it is behaving, is it fine or not? So I can use my oscilloscope. So I'm using an oscilloscope at one of the port. So let me simulate it. Calculation finished. Oh, I'm getting something, but I don't know what it is. Okay, this is, I think, if I do it here also. Oh, okay, at this port we are getting the result. Port number 2, I am getting the same result as of in waveform view. Is the voltage signal I'm getting here. So this is how it works. So this is just a introduction that how this software looks like. I have shown you the component libraries of both the softwares, how to connect, how to simulate it, how to analyze it, how to collect the graphs, and it depends upon you only that at which field you can use. One thing I just want you people know that it can be used by engineering students starting from BTEC. Both the softwares can be used in BTEC as well as MTEC, PhD and other defense organization research works. So you can establish your own lab and start working. So I think this is all I have. And any queries, if you people have, you just write it on a comment box or just let me know how you want to clear out the queries.
हेलो, डू यू हैव एनी क्वेरी?